Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode will start with some updates on SpaceX, including the ANASIS-II launch plus the return of Bob and Doug. Then, like always, we have some Boca Chica updates, some unfortunate Starship Mark II news, as well as the latest on Texas Starships. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Beginning this episode is an article from ispreview.co.uk which talks about the Starlink public beta. Apparently, someone did some digging on the Starlink website and found information they shouldn't have. This information was then leaked to give previously unknown info about the beta program. Next, we have the still delayed ANASIS-II launch. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, it's now expected to light its engines tomorrow, Monday, July 20th at 9 p.m. UTC or 5 p.m. EDT. For the final SpaceX info, we have some news from Jim Bridenstine on the return of Bob and Doug. Bridenstine tweeted, "We are targeting an August 1st departure of SpaceX's Dragon Endeavour spacecraft from the International Space Station to bring Bob and Doug home after their historic Launch America mission. Splashdown is targeted for August 2nd. Weather will drive the actual date." So looks like these two will soon return from a very historic flight. Now we can move over to Boca Chica and check out what's been happening over there. Firstly, we have this pile of scrap that is being called Scrap Town, with all sorts of things from old Starship pieces to single rings and even rolls of steel. They've recently been working on breaking these bits up to be scrapped properly. Next up, we have work continuing to progress over by the Super Heavy launch pad. Currently, they are still working on the foundations for the launch pad, but it's progressing quite well, as you will see now. Here we have a great view and you can actually see what is going on over there. Just quickly, I want to add a little promo for RGV Aerial Photography, who captured this great image. They are looking to do weekly flyovers, but it's very expensive to hire the Cessna and pilot needed for the trips. If you can, please go and support their Patreon via the link in the description. Based on what we can see here though, this is going to be one very beefy launch mount, I think. Also, on the talk of launch mounts, here we have a view of the latest one to be spotted. Not sure just yet, but it's being assumed that it's either the old one being rebuilt or it's a new launch mount. Either way, it's still just currently sitting outside. Over in the production area of the facility, we recently saw workers moving dirt and preparing for an expansion. You can see here that they are continuing to do groundwork. Whilst I was thinking that they might be extending the facility for more buildings, new information possibly says otherwise. Here you can see another amazing aerial view from Mauricio at RGV Aerial Photography. He posted this on Twitter and asked what they could potentially be working towards with this groundwork. Just to the right of the work they are doing, you can see a little house I believe used to belong to Boca Chica Maria. Maria Pointer, or Boca Chica Maria, responded to RGV on Twitter with some interesting info. She said, "There isn't electrical or ground prep for infrastructure. I'm guessing one huge parking lot with the house being included eventually, as well as the corner lot next door on San Martin Boulevard. We heard 4 years ago a tank farm was going in behind us from landowner that wouldn't sell. Near to where this new area is being cleared, there is the newest fabrication building with something interesting inside. It's being called the crew office arm and is a shipping container styled to look like the crew access arm. Also inside this building, there was another new item that was spotted being moved about. Here we have a little stand to roll sections around the yard, and I may be wrong, but looks to me like that's what the recent metal components were for." Also over at the construction area, we have the latest work on the high bay, which you can see has progressed. Right now, it looks like they've been working to add the metal platform-like components to the outside. Finally, for the Boca Chica updates, you can see we have some wooden crates sitting by the fabrication tents. Apparently, these are fragile as they contain critical flight hardware. Quickly before we look at the Boca Chica Starship updates, we have some news from Florida and the Starship over there. For those who don't know, while SpaceX were constructing Mark 1 in Texas, a parallel build was happening in Florida with Mark 2. In this fantastic shot by Julia Bergeron, you can see the second Starship that was being constructed some months ago. However, after months of sitting outside near the main rocket action in Cape Canaveral, we have to say goodbye. Mark 2, as you can see, is currently in the process of being deconstructed with the upper dome and rings already removed. Mark 2 likely served as a great pathfinder build, but beyond that has served no other purpose than a reminder of the rapidly evolving Starship plans. Back over in Texas, SpaceX have reportedly filed a request with the FCC for Starship flights. This Business Insider article says that the company is asking for permission with Starship flights planned up to 12.5 miles within the next 7 months. The company has recently received licenses for Starship flights from the FAA, but they also need permission from the FCC. Now let's take a quick look at SN5 with testing dates, quick view of SN6 and future Starship pieces. Firstly, SN5 is still sitting there being worked on with testing still to happen. Most recently, engineers were spotted working on some bits on top of the prototype. They also seem to have been doing some welding work with the mass simulator on top. Preparations must be coming near to an end soon. We were expecting testing many times in many of my recent videos, to which each date was delayed again and again. They've been delayed even further when I checked yesterday, there was a closure for today, July 19th. As you can see though, this testing date has since been cancelled with backup dates of tomorrow, July 20th and Tuesday, July 21st. As you will all know, whilst SN5 awaits its rounds of testing, SN5 is hanging out in the mid bay. Engineers, as you can see, were seen working on the tank section some more. Finally, for the rest of the video, let's see what new Starship bits have been worked on and spotted. Firstly, we have a view of the recently stacked fairing section with one of the new nose cones which have thrusters. In this great shot, you can see the new nose cones to the right and the old Mark 1 nose cone to the left. Here is a closer view of the old and new fairing section in a more side-by-side comparison. You can really see the quality difference in terms of build. It will be exciting to see a full Starship with the new fairing section. I'm going to just throw this shot into the mix because I think it's cool with 4 different nose cones in one shot. We recently saw SpaceX's moving the old Mark 1 fins that were for months sitting by the side of the road. You can see that these fins have been moved yet again, and also work has been done on them. Nothing too exciting, but they've had a nice clean. Elsewhere in the construction yard, we have some new rings that have been spotted sitting outside. Here you can see a new 3-ring stack sitting outside, along with a small tapered section of a nose cone I believe has been there for a bit. Also, we have another view of the new 3-ring stack and tapered section, along with another stack of rings. So, recently moved outside were 2 ring stack comprised of 3 rings each. As always, there's further ring action spotted with this single ring being moved into one of the onion tents. Also spotted outside, you can see here a very clean looking stack of 3 rings. Not sure if this is another angle of one of the ring stacks we just saw, but look at the quality of this stack. Also, just in the bottom right of the left tent, you can see more stainless steel rings being worked on. On top of these ring stacks that have been sitting outside, a bulkhead and ring stack was spotted inside. Whilst it's uncertain what these will be for, it's likely the second SN7 tank or SN8. As well, even more ring stacks were spotted sitting inside tents. Production seems to really be picking up at the moment. Just to add some more content, because as I'm making this video, more footage is coming to light of even more production work. You can see here that SpaceX have also now moved a couple of thrust section stacks outside for further work. As always, a massive thank you goes to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, who spends hours outside filming. Also, a thank you to Julia Berger and Jack Bayer and the rest of the NASA spaceflight team for all their incredible work too. Without this team of awesome people, these detailed updates would not be possible, so thanks to all of you. Also, I want to say thanks to Mauricio at RGB Aerial Photography for his effort getting the awesome aerial views. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.